In this tutorial, I am going to discuss a programming question, move zeros, and it is the day 4 LeetCode challenge. So the problem statement is, given an array of integers, we have to write a code to move all zeros to the end. And also we have to maintain the relative order of the non-zero elements. So in the first example, you can see all the non-zero elements are moved at the front of the array and all the zero elements are moved at the end, and you can see its order. So first 1, then 2 3 2. So when we move all the non-zero element at the front, we maintain the relative order. So 1, then 2, then 3, then 2, and then all the zeros at the end. And now let's see the second example. In this example, similarly, 6, 9, 11 move at the front of the array and both the zeros move at the end of the array. So this is the problem statement, and we have to solve this problem in place without making a copy of the array. So let's discuss how we can solve this problem. Let's assume this is our input array and we have to move all zeros to the end. So what's the simplest strategy to move all the zeros to the end without using any extra space? So what we can do is, we can traverse this array and we first move all non-zeros element at the front of the array. And then what we can do is, we can put all the zeros element at the end. So let's visualize it. So what we can do is, we take one variable count, and let's, so count will point the first element of the array, and then we traverse this array, and what we check, if the element present at that index is not equal to 0, then what we can do is, we can put at the front and increment the value of count. So let's say the first element is non-zero element. No, it is 0. So in next iteration, we move at this. So I pointer moves at this index and count is remain as it is. Then it is non-zero element. Yes. So what we can do is, so in the same array, we overwrite the value at 0th index. So we move 6 here and then we increment the value of count. And in next iteration, I moves here. So I'm talking about this loop, and count point at this index. So is this a non-zero element? No. So this condition is skipped, and again I move at this index. And is this a non-zero element? Yes. So what we do is, we put 9 here and we increment the value of count. Now count points at this index, and I point in next iteration, I point at this index. So is this a non-zero element? Yes. So let's put 11 here and increment the value of count. So count points at this index, and I already reach at the end. So after that, we came out of this loop, and count point at this index. It means we have still two position left in this array. So what we do is, we run a while loop and we check if the count is less than the length. So length is the original length of an array. So what we can do is, simply put 0. So simply put 0 here and then 0 here, and we came out of this loop as well. So we have moved all zeros to the end and non-zeros to the front of the array. And here I am printing the result so that you get the idea that we have moved all non-zero element at the front and zero at the end. So let's talk about its time and space complexity. So its time complexity is On, and its space complexity is O1, as we have not used any extra space here. So let's run this code and see its output. So you can see this is the input array I have declared here, and I am calling this method. So if I run this code, you can see its output. All the non-zeros element is moved to the front and all the zeros element moves at the end of an array. So that's it for this video tutorial, and For more such programming videos, tutorials, you can subscribe our YouTube channel. You can visit our website, which is https://webrewrite.com. And please don't forget to like this video. If you know any other approach to solve this problem, you can discuss us through your comments. And thanks for watching this video.